the horror and fear that man has, on the one hand, of nothingness, and on the other, of eternity, is manifested everywhere, and we cannot understand this nevermore completely. It questions the habitual, clumsy way of conceiving the irreversibility of time, and cracks our faith in an impenetrable and monolithic reality, whose solid structure and inalterable substrate resists the protoform mutations of time. From this point of view, reality manifests itself not as something given that simply precedes subjective experience. It is like an open and subjective quarry, a construction that is always unfinished. Through the little fissure created by the déjà vu, this reality shows an effort for keeping in time the total sense of life itself. It is a common sensation, that of crossing the threshold of a terrifying world, because it shakes our temporal, logical, and emotional faculties, converting the past and the present into something that one can correct according to our wishes and fears.
The horror and fear
that man has,
on the one hand
of nothingness, and on the other of eternity,
is manifested everywhere.
And we cannot understand this nevermore completely. It questions the habitual,
clumsy way
of conceiving the irreversibility of time, and cracks our faith.
Whose solid structure and inalterable substrate. From this point of view, reality manifests itself not as something given, but simply receives subjective experience. It is like an open and subjective quarry, a construction that is always unfinished. Through the little fissure created by the déjà vu, this reality shows an effort for keeping in time the total sense of life itself. It is a common sensation, that of crossing the threshold of a terrifying world, because it shapes our temporal, logical, faculties. Converting the past and the present into something that one,
into something that one can correct
according to our wishes
and fears. The horror and fear that man has, on the one hand of...
The horror and fear that man has,
on the one hand of nothingness, and on the other of eternity,
is manifested everywhere, and we cannot understand this nevermore completely.
It questions the habitual, clumsy way of conceiving the irreversibility of time, and it cracks our
faith in an impenetrable and monolithic reality, whose solid structure and inalterable substrate resists our proto-form mutations of time.
Reality manifests itself, not as something given,
simply
precedes subjective experience. It is like an open and subjective quarry. A construction that is always unfinished. Through the little fissure created by the déjà vu, this reality shows an effort for keeping in time the total sense.
From this point of view, reality manifests itself not as something given that simply precedes subjective experience. It is like an open and subjective quarry, a construction that is always unfinished. Through the little fissure created by the déjà vu, this reality shows an effort for keeping in time the total sense of life itself.